Things go wrong, and as we come back to in-person events, there will be more opportunities for things to go wrong, as we saw last week with Will Smith and Chris Rock. Let's not talk about that, though. If this is not about them, this is about you, right? So what can we do to prevent things going wrong now that we're starting to travel more? I'd like to share with you three tips that we used in the Bureau that helped us a great deal. So here's tip number one, if you are flying, or even if you're actually taking a train or a piece of transport, don't book yourself on the very last flight out, the very last train, very last ship, whatever it happens to be, because you are taking a risk. Something could go wrong. So what do I mean by that? If you're on the last plane out the night before your event and you're speaking the next morning and that plane is cancelled, diverted, delayed, something goes wrong, you've not got a way then of getting to the event. And the client wants you there, you want to be there, you want to get paid, right? So what I suggest you do is that you book yourself on the second to last so that you have some wriggle room and you have some flexibility in case something goes wrong, just to be safe. I'd also suggest that when you book your travel, it is fully flexible so that if you have to change it for whatever reason, you can do so, and ideally do so without having to contact the client, that you can do it there and then at the airport. So that's my first piece of advice. Don't take the last flight, the last train, the last boat, the last camel, whatever it happens to be, make it the second to last. Yeah. Secondly, I'm smiling because I'm remembering the story. This happened. It's happened many times, but I happened to be there on this occasion. I had booked the lovely, rip-roaring, hilarious speaker, Jeff Birch, to speak. And he was traveling with his wife, Sally, to an event for one of my big clients. And I traveled with them too. Now, we all arrived safely. Sadly, Jeff and Sally's luggage did not. So it meant that Jeff didn't have a stage outfit for his speech the next day. And he had to borrow a piece of clothing from the client. And he borrowed one of their sweatshirts with their logos on. And it wasn't a good colour for him. It was bright orange. You can imagine the picture, right? And of course, poor Sally didn't have any of her cosmetics, any of her toiletries, change of clothes, none of that. So travel with your stage outfit and with your makeup as well in your hand luggage. You don't want to be in a situation where you have to wear a garish orange sweatshirt on stage. Don't let that happen. Okay, so that's another piece of advice. And finally, those of you who know me know that I encourage you to have a well-written introduction to bring you onto stage. It's important. You want to be set up for success. You want to come onto stage and be presented and introduced properly. So you will, because you're professional, you will have sent your introduction in advance to the client and you'll be expecting them to use it. But, and this happened so many times when I attended events with speakers, the person that you sent the introduction to hasn't sent it on or given it to the MC or host for the day, so they don't have it. And they say, oh, don't worry, I'll write my own, I'll read your bio, don't worry. No, you don't want that. You want them to read your introduction as you have written it for them. So always travel with a copy of the introduction with you. In fact, we used to attach it to the speaker's travel summary, so they always had it so they could just rip it off and hand it to the client. If you want to be really, really super safe, print it on a piece of coloured paper so they can't mislay it and laminate it, right? Really, you know, belt and braces there. So my three bits of advice as we start to do things more and more in person: do not book yourself on the last piece of transport. Give yourself some wriggle room with a flexible, fully flexible ticket. Take your outfit with you in your hand luggage. Do not get left wearing your trainers, your gym shorts, whatever you have to travel in, and a client's orange sweatshirt. And finally, take your introduction with you. Set yourself up for success every single time. Okay. Let me know what tips you have. Of course, there are so many more as we go back to being in person. Share yours. I'd love to hear them. Let's get a list together. All right. Take care.